Thank you all for joining me, and welcome back to Icarus. So I'm still working on what the problem is up there. You probably haven't seen the video yet, actually, but of the time we're working, watching this, of me recording this, sorry, of the damage that I'm getting on the interior ward. So I'm a bit ahead. I wasn't meant to be a bit ahead this time, but it just kind of happened because I just kept recording. You know how it is. Hold on a minute. Let me just grab those. So what we're going to do now, I've actually gone ahead and done some more flooring because we was going to do some more flooring anyway. So I'm going to put that up and see if that helps, because we put the walls up, that's still getting damaged. So if I put another ceiling up, which is what I was going to do anyway, and see if that helps. I still think it's to do with the actual, the amount of space that's in there. It's a bit too big, but I could be wrong. Now, I did actually get some furniture, but if you check this out, look. Have they changed it? I can't remember when they changed this, because this can go outside. It usually shows if there's no shelter. So I've got a feeling they've changed that. But the thing is, though, the game changes constantly every week, and it's easy to miss certain things that they've changed. So it is what it is. I do feel like at one point this game's going to get so bloated it's going to be unbelievable. What I've done is I've gone ahead and I've actually made 81 floors here. Also, what I'm doing as well is I'm going to show you, I'm actually getting ready to actually get all the actual stuff ready for going to the Arctic. I know we're not finished here yet, but I just kind of wanted to get ahead and get ready for that. So as you can see, we've got a load of electrical parts here for the material processor, for this, for the foundry. For the electric furnace and all this stuff here. We haven't done that though. Although technically I don't really need that, but I might do it anyway. And obviously we've got that one to do as well. And then obviously we've already got the fabricator. That's kind of all we need. So yeah. And then all the kitchen stuff we'll sort out when we get there. So let's go ahead and let me just check what I got on me. Let me just go ahead and drop that off first. In fact, what we can do is we can go ahead and grab these and go and place those down. I'm gonna go ahead, I was gonna get some vestiges today. I might still do that. We'll see how I feel. I was gonna go and get some vestiges ready for later on, for when we start placing stuff down with decorations. I do like this though. I do like this. Yeah, you probably haven't seen this yet. Actually, they're recording this, you would see this, hopefully. Okay, so we haven't had a storm recently, so we'll just have to see how this goes. So I was going to put a floor in there. So this is going to be too high. Now, I've never had a problem with it being too high in the past. So we should see, we'll see how this goes. Because this is going to be kind of like an attic at the top. But will that actually help? I do like that top bit there. Kind of wish I did do like a peak thing there. But I never thought of that at the time. Okay, so let's go ahead and place these in. It'd be a shame if we have to change all this. So we could end up wasting materials here doing this, but I mean, at the end of the day, we've got to try and work out what the issue is. But I really think it's to do with the space, but I could be wrong, of course. You might have actually made some digestions, so if this fixes it, then yeah. If not, then I'm looking forward to seeing what your suggestions might be, so that we can actually work it out together. But like I said, I think it's the spacing. Because it's quite a big space, isn't it? If we put this heel up. Now, the thing is, we won't know if the ones at the top are taking damage unless we're actually looking up there. So we're going to go ahead and do this side as well. Because the thing is, though, everything's sheltered. No matter what I where I actually try things out, even if you don't place it down, it'll flash up saying no shelter. And if it needs shelter, then that's what it will do. It looks like they've changed the... I remember doing a playthrough once and I kind of hated the fact that we couldn't put furniture outside. So obviously they must have changed that. So yeah. Right, okay. In fact, you know what I'm thinking? These side bits here. Hold on a minute. Yeah, I'm just wondering whether these side bits here, whether we should just, I don't know, put some kind of like seating area there. There's quite a lot of space to fill up in here, isn't there? So I do like that. I like the fact that you can open the door. In some games, you can't open the door if you've got like the ghost image in your hand. You have to take it out and then do that, but you can open the door with this, so that's good. And so there should be the right amount here. I counted 81, I might be wrong. Oh, that's wrong. How I counted 81, but if I've got my maths correct, it should be fine. Yeah, I think these side bits would be nice little lounges each side that we could have at the top. I'm still debating whether to do like a walk around on floor. There we go. So we have got the right amount. Yay, I got it right. Okay, there we go. So that's all covered. So hopefully that will help. You can see all the bits here. That's from the ones at the top. Now, what we are going to do, in fact, I might do that actually now. So if we actually, no, I might hold off on that because we're going to have some stairs going up here as well. So instead of doing it sort of like going around, I'm going to have it going straight up. So it will go 1, 2, and then it will come into here. And that will take us into the attic there. Okay, so we've sorted that out. So what I'm going to do now is I think we're just going to have to wait for a storm and see what happens and see if anything happens at all. In fact, do you know what? It might be good to have those stairs so we can have actually have a look at the things at the top. So I think I am going to do that if we've got enough stuff here to do it. And we haven't. Oh, crap. Right, I think we just need... Oh, yeah, we have. We've got some nails in here. Cool. We can do that. So I'm going to go ahead and do two of those. Well, actually, stop. We've already got two. We already had one. Let me just go ahead and put those in there. Yeah, so you'll have to let me know, guys. Have they changed the furniture so you can have it outside? I never noticed that. Like I said, so many changes get me into this game. It's hard to keep up sometimes. So what I want to do here, instead of the way we usually do it, but what we've done before, we're just going to have this going straight up, literally straight up. So we're going to go like that. And then like that. So this is going to go straight up from here and then up to here. So that way we can get in there and we can check to see if anything's going to get damaged at the top there. So I think we're going to leave it at that for now and then just see how things go, because I really don't want to be putting stuff in there if it's all going to collapse on us and get destroyed. And I don't really want to be there messing about repairing it. It's okay at the beginning of the game, but when you get to this stage, you don't really want to be doing that, especially if you're doing multiple bases in different locations. And there's a storm, you could end up going back to your base and it's completely destroyed because of the storm. Or there's a little shell of it, which is like, that would be very, very frustrating. Okay, so let's have a look at what we've got here. So I've actually sorted out the masonry bench, I think. So the masonry bench, oh yeah, we're going to need 60 steel for that. I've already got the cement mix. We're going to need 60 steel though. So I'm going to grab that. And we've got a weathering... Oh, it's only a light one, though. So we'll just have to see whether this takes damage or not. It might not take damage for this anyway, but we'll see. So we need... Oh, wow. 60 of those. And what else was it? It was the cement, wasn't it? So I've already got 100 cement here. So we can go ahead and get that sorted. Masonry bench. I'm just going to type it in. I don't know exactly where it is on the actual thing. Okay, so we've got the masonry bench sorted here. I need to place things in a certain place. Right, okay. Where did I put the fabricator? Where's the fabricator? I think it's in here. Right, I'm going to grab the fabricator. I want to place it somewhere we don't use. Okay, well, we're not really using this. I'm going to grab all that. I might turn that into rope, actually. I'm going to chuck that in there. I'm going to grab all that as well. Chuck that in there. And this is going to be all the stuff we're going to be taking with us. So we've now got that. Oh, a bit of a lag there. Oh, we have got some red things. We're going to go up in a minute and check to see what happens now. So we've got the masonry bench. I've got a feeling it could be the space that's causing this. The huge amount of space. I'm not seeing any numbers fly up or anything like that. Let's get our hammer out. At the moment, there doesn't seem to be any numbers flying up anywhere at the moment. So far, so good. But we're just going to have to hold off and see Hopefully you guys can see it. It's a bit kind of like a red kind of tint thing. Should we take this out? Well, nothing's damaged at the bottom there. And let's go ahead and get these repaired here. So they're all repaired. It was those corner bits that got a lot of damage there as well, weren't they? Not so much the top bits, unless I did manage to... I don't think I would have repaired those anyway, because I would have been able to reach them. But let's see what happens here then. I know we're just waiting here to see what happens, but we really, really need to work out whether this is right or not. I think this is going to be the... where's the doors there? So we've got a door there, haven't we? I think we could put a door here and a door there. We can have a couple of lounges there. But like I say, I think I might actually do a walk around on the floor below us. Once we've worked all this out, I think that would look cool having that going around. And gives a good view instead of looking through a murky window as well. So far so good. We're not getting any damage, but this is a green one. It's not exactly a bad storm. It's still bad enough as we've got red bars there. This is the first bar we're coming up to, so we'll soon find out if we get any numbers or anything like that flying up and stuff. I mean, we could sort of like, yeah, that would make it too small up there. Well, not really. Although that's free up in it, so we'd have to get more stairs going up there. Christ, I've done this pretty big, haven't I? I don't think, because I wanted to do three small builds on this rather than one big build, but I always get carried away. I think we all do that, don't we? We all get carried away sometimes. So I think this could have fixed it. We're coming into the red bar now, so we'll soon find out whether we get any damage from this at all. And we're getting damage. Okay. So that hasn't fixed it. The thing is, though, is that doing it at these as well? Yep. Yeah, it's all getting damaged again. I haven't got a clue. I really haven't got a clue what's causing this. Just put that back. Yeah, this is... Hold on a minute. Right, we'll just have to wait for another storm. Well, none of this, because if we put the roofing in there, none of this has got damaged. Doesn't look like. But the wall there did, didn't it? Maybe because I put that thing there. I don't know. Yeah, none of this has got damaged. And this was getting damaged before, wasn't it? Before we put that floor up. So, yeah, none of... Oh, hold on a minute. Yeah, we are getting some damage here. Damn you, game. You're so annoying. Right. Well, I think if we'll get... yeah, I think the only other option we might have is... maybe to just do another floor there and see if that helps. And if not, we're just going to have to change it to concrete or something like that. And hopefully furniture won't get damaged. But it looks like they've changed it. And I can't remember when they did that. So I'm just going to put that back on for now. I mean, that wasn't a very bad storm, but we've still got a little bit of damage there. So we just have to see. Yeah, I don't know. I'm a bit annoyed by that, but hopefully we can work it out. And I don't think it's the glass window walls. I know some people might say it's because you're using glass walls. That should not make any difference at all, because at the end of the day, it still acts as a wall. The only difference is how strong it is rather than the actual, you know, this is. But the actual glass walls aren't getting damaged at all as well. So I have checked that. The glass walls aren't getting damaged whatsoever. They've got no damage on them at all. But the interior wood in the inside of it is. So that doesn't make any sense, because it should be the glass walls getting damaged before the interior wood gets damaged on the inside. But that's the nature of games sometimes. They don't always make sense. Right, so where did we get to? So let's have a look here. So I did the... We put them in here, didn't we? Yeah, so we've actually got to the masonry bench. We've got the fabricator. I do want the furnace, the electric furnace as well. Let's have a look at what else we need for that. Oh, I forgot about the concrete mix. So we need 80 concrete mix. So how much stuff have I got and how much stone have I got? We could get some of that done, I guess. We haven't got any stone. Yeah. Okay. I've got a little bit of stone in there. Yeah, we've got a bit of, yeah. I mean, we can start this off. We probably won't be able to make it straight away, but I'm actually going to need more than that, though. I need to drop this, tell you what, let's just drop it off in here, shall we? Let's just drop that off there. Okay, so. Yeah, so we're just waiting on that. Well, that's not going to be enough. That is definitely not going to be enough. Where's the stone? We've got stone. Oh, it's there, 43 stone, so we haven't got enough stone. Right, so I'm going to have to sort that out next time then. So we can't do the electric furnace. Let's try the material processor. Yeah. I mean, we've got the carbon fiber, titanium plates we can do. Carbon fiber, titanium plates, and aluminium. We can do aluminium. I've been actually cooking up some aluminium in, actually. So 30 aluminium. Fact, have we actually got any down here? Aluminium. Got 30 of those then. And I think we need 3, 6, 9 titanium. Yeah, 9 titanium. I think. That'll give us 3 titanium plates. I believe it was titanium plates, wasn't it? Yeah, okay. We'll go ahead and do that. We'll chuck that in there, and we want the material processor. Oh yeah, we need the carbon fiber as well. Hold on a minute. Have we actually got any carbon fiber at all? I don't think we have. Nope. Okay, so we need 8 carbon fibers. So let's have a look at what we need for that. Oh yes, yes, of course. So we are going to need 16, 32. There's 16 of those. Let's get some sulfur then. I'm just going to make what we actually need. 32 of these. It's just so, just in case we need other stuff to actually craft anything else. 16, 32. We need 8 aluminium. And 8 of these. Oh, hold on a minute. It's aluminium. We got that, didn't I? Got that. Okay. So we should be able to get 8 of these done now. Get those cooked up and then we should be good. How long have we been? Yeah, I might just go out. Have I actually got... Yeah, I have got my taxidermy. You can use the actual backpack from the actual station if you want. I have got it. I think I've got it on a different playthrough and I forgot to bring it back. But, so I don't really want to go and buy another one if I don't need to. So, but I've got the taxidermy knife anyway, so it's fine. So let's go ahead and put that in there. That'll give us what we need for that. Well, at least then we've got the... Was that for the material? It was for the material processor, wasn't it, I think. Let's have a look. Oops. The material processor. Yeah, so we just need it for that. Let me just check the foundry. What do we need for the foundry? Yeah, we need 15 concrete mix. We can get the 15 concrete mix, but we do need 5. So we need 15 titanium plates. Okay. Let's go and do that then. 15 titanium plates. Oh, it's 5 titanium plates, but we need 15 to make 5. That's right. How far down is this? Can I just scroll down? Yeah, there it is. That's another 5 of those. And then 15. Drop those. And we need 15 Oh, we haven't got enough stone. Damn it. Okay, that's fine. We'll leave that for now then. Okay, so we can't do the foundry. Oh, we need to go and grab the thing, don't we? Let's go ahead and do that. Oh, it's not in there, is it? It's in here. There we go. So we've got that now. Okay, so we want the material processor. That's what I meant. Okay, so we'll craft that up. And there we go. So we're starting to get there. We're getting some of the most expensive things out of the way. So we've got the electric masonry bench table with us. We've got the material processor. We've also got the fabricator. And then obviously we've got the foundry. We've also got the other stuff as well. And then obviously the glass masonry bench and stuff like that. Maybe we'll obviously want to get one of those as well. Just so that we're all set up. So I'm going to leave it at that for now. I'm going to wait for your comments on that video to see what the problem is with that. But there is another option I can do where I can do another floor, which is going to take away from the skyline, isn't it, really? Which is annoying. And if that helps, then that helps. If not, then I think I'm just going to have to change it to concrete, unfortunately. I don't think there's any other option from what I can see there. So, I tell you what, let's go ahead and let's go and get some stuff. What do I need to repair that, actually? Iron. I thought it was iron. Yeah, it was iron, wasn't it? Yeah, let's grab a 20 stack and put that in there for repairs. Yo, oh, I need to drop all this stuff off now, don't I? Slightly different video today. We'll just do it, just grinding stuff out and stuff and checking on how to fix certain stuff. I'm actually going to leave the sticks in here with the wood, you know. No, not that. Actually, yeah, no. I'll just leave that in there. And I'll leave that in there because we'll probably use that. I need to drop that off. That seat in there. Let's go ahead and do that. Right, what time are we on? Yeah, okay. So, let's go ahead and see if we can get some decent vestiges. Scorpions and stuff like that. And see what we can come up. I mean, obviously we've got antelope and stuff we can get. They're pretty easy to get. Do I really want to go? Right, I want you to follow me when I'm not on you. Okay. So we've got that. Yeah, let's just take it all. Got it here. Yeah, I've got the head there. I've got another one. Another antelope here. Right, I'm going to get a couple of crocodiles as well. We're going to need... what else is there? Oh yeah, we've got the cougars, haven't we? Crocodiles. So we've got two of those so far. Zebras. Hyenas. Sure you're not. Where are you? There you are. Alright, so we've got a zebra here. Okay, so we've got the zebra there. I'll just take it all. I'm gonna try and get two of each if we can. We don't have to go too far, I guess. Thank you. That was close. Yeah, they're cougars. Oh my god. All right, so we've got a cougar there. Got a scorpion. Oh, wow. It's just not, it's just the instinct doing that, going for the bones. Okay, we've got a hyena. Right. I do want to get crocodiles as well. Right, let's go down and see if we can get some crocodiles. Have we just got the one? Right, we've got, yeah, we've got two of those. We've got, yeah, I need another one of those. We've just got the one zebra, okay. Right, and I still haven't sorted out the fish thing yet. We'll sort that out. I think I might go through some of the recipes and see if we can actually cook them up. There's so many, and you don't miss it. I mean, some of them have similar stats, and some of the stats you get, I feel that you don't really need. This one's a good one, especially when you're grinding it out. You get that extra 20% melee attack for, not so much for the actual attacking things, but for mining and stuff like that. So let's go ahead and see if we can find some crockies down here. Do I really need my light on? Doesn't make much difference, is it? Let me guess, you're in the... Hello. You see me? I'm here. I don't really want to go in the water. I'm here. Come get me. Wish I could throw a stone at it. That would have been cool. Try and get its attention. I kind of want to do it on ground. It's just easier. Well, hold on a minute. Ah, just get off. There we go. So we've got our second cougar there. We are getting a bit full, but I do want to grab all the stuff that we can from them as well. So we've got our second cougar. Oh, there's a zebra. Damn you, bitch. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry about the profanity. Since I don't know where that come from. That was just very, very random. I'll try and remember to cut that out. I believe we just did that. Okay. That just made me laugh. Oh god. Right. Okay. Anyway, let's concentrate and get on with what we're doing. Right. Where's this crocodile? I know we've seen that one crocodile. I should have just gone in. Should have got it. Right. So we've got two zebras now. We've got two cougars. We've got two antelopes. It's kind of what I want to. We don't need to go overboard with it. Yeah, see anything. Oh, we've got the hyena. We've already got two zebras now, so we've got the second hyena. Alright, come on, where's these crocs? I know we've seen one, but there's got to be more than one here. See any health bars anywhere? I remember doing fishing here, and not this playthrough, another one. The last one, I think. It was actually on this island here, I'm sure it was. Here we go. Let's just reload just to make sure. They're not easy to kill, these ones. Oh, and I get a shot on it straight away. A good shot on it straight away. So we've got our first croc. Now I really feel like an Aussie. Okay. So I want one more of those. Was there one over there? I think there's one over there, look. Oh, I can see one there, look. Okay, so we'll get this one. I think we're going to make this the last one for today, at least. Call it a day. Been a bit of a strange video today, but something I wanted to sort out. I mean, I'm going to have to go out now and get some stone and stuff like that. It's a pain in the ass getting stone in the desert, so I might just head back to the first base in the forest. And, yeah. And just grab a load of stone. There we go. So, in fact, we've not got everything, have we? We've only got one scorpion, haven't we? Yeah, one scorpion. So I can easily get one of those at some point. At least we've got one for now. And I can get those. Get that at any time. So, yeah, I am going to call it here, guys. Thank you so much. Take care. And I'll see you in the next one.